I'm here at the Reseda Sports Club. It's open 9 to 9. Tolik, tell people your address.
7023 Reseda Boulevard, City Reseda, open 9 to 9.
What does it cost for me to come train here for a month?
$30 a month, year 200. Just use the facility only. You have classes, full classes, kids, adults, 130 a month. Include, use the facility. That's it.
You have two rings, it's a
I
big gym?
I have two rings, full okay. Boxing equipment.
So
rings.
Somebody's watching this video and they say, you know what, I love boxing, I want to try. Let's say it's their first day in the gym. What do you tell them, Tolik, your first day, first week? Like, how does it work? They walk in here. Do they need to bring their own gloves, their own wraps?
Yeah, I'm trying. Look, okay. You guys don't have to forget, we live in a country, everybody wants to do business. I have gloves for sale. I'm trying. Of course, I tell, okay, you have two options. You can buy my own gloves and you can use gloves. This is, again, give them opportunity. I don't let them, oh, you have to buy. No, you can use gloves.
But
you
it's better new. To buy new ones. Yeah. It's not that expensive, right?
It's like 80 bucks, 70 okay. bucks. You can buy a new pair of quality gloves. Okay. But if not, you can use the used one.
Okay.
Number two, hand wraps. The hand wraps, you can buy new one or you $5 or you can take a used one.
Okay.
Like normally. Everything else, it's normal. Headgears, we provide. Everything else, we provide. Now, the first time kids come to the gym, I just tell them, bring the water, bring their shoes, and like start training. We'll see what's up.
And what do you do when someone comes here? Like, some kids know how to train, know how to box because their father taught them, their uncle, their grandfather. Some people have zero knowledge. So when someone has no knowledge, totally, what do you do with
that? Coordination. So the first thing, we start from coordination. All coordination, the style is supposed to be set before we start boxing. Because people come to gym and start, they come from gym from different sport, from swimming, from gymnastic, from, I don't know, from soccer player. So they different coordination. So we start teach a little bit more coordination stuff. And kids like 5, 6 years old just flip overs, jump, just catch the ball, jumps and all this stuff. And after you move to up to next step to boxing stuff.
What is the boxing stuff? Do you start with the footwork?
Footwork, yeah, the boxing stuff from the step, left, right.
Show
left.
Us like you
step,
the basic.
Step front, step back, step right, step left. After you make one leg back, one leg front, one leg right.
This is before you even threw one punch.
But after you throw a jab, so you control your jab, your shoulder, your wrist, you throw right. You have to be balanced here in the middle. You never sit like this or you never sit like that. So you have to be like straight balanced in the middle. After you make step, jab, step, right, step, left, right, step, right, left. So this is basically just straight punches, like first 3 months straight punches.
And 3 months, that, and then they pick months. It up from there.
And hooks, uppercuts, spread. If you keep staying in the gym, but sometimes people just get out.
It's hard. It's a hard sport. It's not easy.
It's not easy. It's super annoying. And sometimes I be screaming. People just doesn't like that. If people just go away to do taekwondo, karate. It's more fun there. And trainers just say, oh, you're good. Nobody say you're good here. Always you say you're bad.
Why? Why do you always tell your fighters
because
they suck?
Because you're never good. How are you going to good?
You're gonna, how you going to get better?
You come to gym for 2 weeks. How you want to be good? You're not going to hear you're good. You're bad. But you're going to be good. You have potential. But for now, you're falling.
But how about this, Tolik? If I play basketball and I take a year off, I step on the court, I'm perfect. You do boxing, you take a week off, it's like you have to start from scratch.
Muscle memory.
Why?
Still you have muscle memory, but I know. It depends who. Some people need break and you come to gym and do everything okay. And some people just come to gym and they can't memorize shit. You tell them every day. You tell them right straight. You have to turn your leg. They come again like this. The same mistakes. I mean, it's everybody different. Like in school, you have 40 kids, 40 students. One of them the best. One of them horrible. Same thing in boxing.
When you grew up in Russia and you boxed, did you have speed bags in Russia?
No.
Okay, why not? Why don't they use it in England? Why don't they use it overseas?
Okay, let me tell you. Soviet Union, now probably all gyms, everybody has speed bag. They copy United States and copy the old gym and probably there. But back in the days, we used, I just want to tell you, heavy bags. And we used, on the wall, there was back like this, like back,
yeah.
Huge back on the wall. And it's a lot of back
numbers, angles. Yeah,
they have even angles, numbers. There was back on the wall.
I've
heavy
seen those.
Bags,
yeah,
no double ends. Let me tell you, it's gonna be. Who knows? The back in the days, 80s, skis. Somebody does skis. You know, ski. They put ski They put ski one skis in press, and it's just used like double end and used like double end ski. It's unbelievable. It's a joke. It sounds like joke today. People say, "Oh, guys, crazy," but this is was like that.
And that's how you trained with the ski.
There was skis there. The gym. There was heavy bag, tires. The 3-4 tires, like hook up three with belts and hit the tires. This was like very, very simple equipment. Today you have speed bags. I built myself. This speed bag I built myself. Nobody make those speed bags. I built myself by these hands.
Wow,
so
that's
this is
pretty cool.
Bag I did. It took me 6 months to build it.
What did you do? You had to take the
wood. I make him dry for 3 months, dry food, and I put ten coats of glue and put this.
It looks very professional.
I have three of them.
Well, you made all of them.
I made all of them. Nobody made that.
Okay. I see you have this. Some gyms have a treadmill. What do you prefer?
I have treadmill, manual treadmill.
What do you prefer?
I prefer bike.
Why?
And climber.
Climber, you told me last time. I remember.
Yeah, climber the best and bike.
Why?
Look, treadmill, manual. The manual treadmill I have in the bag for sprints, we use perfect. For running, I mean, run outside. Why you have a treadmill? It's easy. The motor work, electric motor work, they make you run. It's easy. I mean, it's okay, but it's not like bike. You sit on the bike, you make workout a little bit. This is climber the best. You make sprints.
Hands and legs. Yeah,
this is expensive equipment, but this is the best one. And they, I mean, a lot of things. You have swim, you have bike, everything. Not like treadmill.
You know, you're right, and I'll tell you why. Because Chavez Jr. was training in Big Bear, and I went jogging with him. I could do an hour in a treadmill, no problem, at any speed.
Outdoor?
10 minutes, I was dead. I went with him for 45 minutes, but I was hurting. Like,
so
10 minutes.
The treadmill, and you run outside. When you come to the ring, it's nobody move the ring between your legs, so you have to move your legs by yourself. Even you run on treadmill 3 hours, and you guzzling in the ring, this finish after 3 rounds, and fighter gonna say, "Oh, what the fuck, man, I don't have power." Yeah, you don't have power because you idiot. You run on your treadmill in your gym 3 hours instead of being fucking on the beach or in the forest or whatever. You understand? It's like different treadmill.
Okay, last thing. How do you make people lose weight, Tolik? What's your advice? If a fighter needs
nutrition.
To lose weight. That's it, key is nutrition.
Nutrition. Training number three. Nutrition number one. You make nutrition. 100% nutrition. Shakes. I give advice, I can give advice already, I have enough experience to give advice to a lot of trainers. If you have to lose a lot of weight and if you don't want to kill the fighter, liquid food. It's tough, but you lose weight like very fast. Liquid food, shakes. So you make NutriBullet shake and you put all ingredients, what you have to put, and all vitamins, all minerals, what the body needs. So you're not gonna be dizzy. You have the energy enough, but liquid food. But weight goes down very fast.
All right, that's
anytime,
for sure.
Liquid food, just go.
Equal,
go.
Right? What's it called? Equal? It's what old people eat always in a grocery store, Ralph's. You have it's like protein shakes. Like,
no, you can do different options. I do shake every day. All vegetables, fruits.
Yeah.
You can put a little bit protein, whatever you want.
But not solid food so much.
No.
But it works.
It's liquid food, it's perfect.
All right, there you have it. Tolik, one more time, tell people the address here.
7023 Reseda Boulevard, City Reseda, 91335 zip code, open 9 to 9, $30 a month, $200 a year.
And be serious if you come.
Yeah, if you come, you're serious. If you, if you come not serious, just pay money and get out. No problem.
So there you have it, another great video for ES News. For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Eli Sekpak, reporting, and you can follow me on Twitter, at Sekpak. And you can follow me on Instagram, at Eli Sekpak.